Good afternoon, Year 6. How are you all? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. So once again, welcome to Best Montessori Distance Learning ePortal. Now, as you all have told last time that you are finding some problem in the topic pronoun, so that is why today I have decided to do revision of pronoun with you all. So let us start. First of all, what is a pronoun? Now this you must have been doing from from year 2, the definition of pronoun, that simple definition of pronoun, that pronoun is the word that is used in the place of the noun. The word that is used in place of the noun, that is called pronoun. For example, he, she, it, her, etc. Now see, if I say a few sentences about any student, so for example, I am talking about Pramshu. Okay, I want to say a few sentences about Pramshu. I am speaking like this. Pramshu is the student of year 6. He is a very good student. Pramshu is a student of year 6. Pramshu is a very good student. Pramshu is a good football player. Pramshu is well-behaved student. Pramshu does his homework very nicely. Pramshu obeys the rules of the school. Pramshu is an obedient boy. Is it looking nice? When you are hearing to it, is it looking nice? Every time I'm speaking out the name of Pramshu, Pramshu, Pramshu in these sentences. Now, the same sentences if I speak in another way. Pramshu is the student of year 6. He is very good student. He is a good football player. He does his homework very nicely. He is an obedient boy. He obeys the rules of the school. He is a good football player. So now which one is, do you think, is more appropriate? The first one, in which I was taking the name of Pramshu again and again, or in this paragraph, in which I have replaced Pramshu with he? Of course, the second stanza, in which the name of Pramshu is replaced with he. Only first time I took the name of Pramshu, that Pramshu is a student of year 6. After that, I replaced Pramshu with he. So in this paragraph, he is the pronoun, because Pramshu is a name of a person and Pramshu is a noun. I have replaced noun with he, so he is your pronoun. So such type of words which are used in place of noun, they are known as pronoun. For example, he, she, it, her, etc. I hope you must have understood now what is a pronoun. Okay, let us move to next now. What are the different types of pronoun? In lower classes, you must have done like two types of pronoun, that is personal pronoun and possessive pronoun. Now you are in year 6, so you have to do all the types of pronoun. So mainly there are 7 types of pronoun. How many types? 7 types of pronouns. Number 1 is personal pronoun. Now as the name is indicating itself, personal pronoun. Personal means what? Personal means belonging to a particular person. So the pronouns that take place of person, place or things is called personal pronoun. Now this pronoun includes 3 types of person, that is first person, second person and third person. First person means who is doing the work or who is talking. Second person means to whom that person is talking. And third person means about whom we are talking. For example, now through this slideshow, I am talking to you people and I am talking about Pramshu. So who is the first person here? I. Because I am talking to you, so I will be the first person. To whom I am talking? To you, to year 6. So you people are the second person. And third person is who? I am talking about Pramshu, so Pramshu is the third person. So in this way, we can say that for first person is I and the plural of I is we. Second person is you to whom I am talking, and plural of you will be also you only. Third person is he, she, it, they. It can be any. It can be he, it can be she, it can be it can be they, anybody. They is the plural form. They is the plural form of he and she. So this first person, second person and third person together form your personal pronouns. So if you find any of this pronoun in the sentence, it means that is a personal pronoun, and you should be able to recognize whether it is a first person, second person or third person. First person means the person who is speaking or talking or doing the work. Second person means the person to whom you are speaking, with whom you are talking. And third person is about whom you are talking. Both of you, about whom you are talking. That is the third person. Now, second type of pronoun is possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun means what? Pronouns that show possession. Possession means belongingness. This thing is belonging to me. That thing is belonging to you. Showing the possession that these things are possessed by me. They are called possessive pronouns. For example, mine, yours, hers, his, etc. For example, if I say, these books are yours. So it means what? That this particular set, these books, means I am pointing out towards a particular set of books that these books are yours. I am telling that the belonging, that these books are possessed by you. So here yours will be your possessive pronoun. So if you see any type of this type of pronoun in the sentence like mine, yours, hers, his, etc., then that will be your possessive pronoun. Theirs, all these are your possessive pronoun. Then third is demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun means the pronouns that are used to, pronouns that are used to point out object or objects. Again, the same thing, like just now I told, these books are yours. Now, these books means I am pointing towards a particular set of books. These books, I am pointing towards the particular set of books. So, that when we are pointing towards a particular set of objects, then that means demonstrative pronoun. For example, that, this, these, those, etc. This pencil is mine. This marker is mine. This marker means I am having a particular marker. I am showing a particular marker, and that marker is only my marker. So when I am pointing towards a particular thing, then or an object, then that means demonstrative pronoun. So for example, that, this, these, those, etc. So if you see these type of pronouns in the sentence like that, this, these, those, etc., then they are the demonstrative pronouns. I hope you must have understood these three types. Personal pronoun means taking the place of a person, place or a thing. For example, it includes first person, second person, third person. Then possessive pronoun means showing possession, that particular set of things are belonging to a particular person, to me, to you, to him, to her, like that. Then demonstrative pronoun means pointing towards the particular object or objects, like this book, that copy, this pen, those markers, these erasers. I am pointing towards a particular set of objects, then that is demonstrative pronoun. Now next comes your interrogative pronoun. Interrogative, as the name is indicating, interrogative means what? Pronouns that are used to ask questions. Very simple. Like what, who, which, etc. All the pronoun, all the words which are used to ask the questions, they are your interrogative pronouns. What is your name? Which is your book? Who is coming in the class? All this are your interrogative pronouns. The pronouns that are used to ask questions. So I hope that these four types of pronouns must be clear to you now. personal pronoun was showing it includes first person, second person, third person. First person means who is talking, second person to whom I am talking, and third person about whom I am talking. Possessive pronoun means showing the possession, like mine, yours, hers, his, etc. Demonstrative pronoun means pointing towards particular object or objects, like that, this, these, those, etc. Interrogative means pronouns that are used to ask questions like what, who, which, etc. Now, these four types of pronouns are very simple pronouns which you can easily find out in the sentence and tell that which type of pronouns are these. Now, let us talk about three more types of pronouns, because in total there are how many types? There are seven types of pronouns in total. So, now let us talk about three more types of pronouns. Now, the next three types of pronouns, fifth type of pronoun is your relative pronoun. Relative pronouns, what are these pronouns? Pronouns that are used to relate the parts of the sentence. For example, now see again, in the example, who, that, whom, whose, etc. is coming. Now see, who, whom, whose, you will be confused with this now. Who, whom, whose, they are used in interrogative pronouns also. You will ask me this question, that they are used to ask the question, so they are the interrogative pronouns. So how you will differentiate between interrogative and relative pronoun? See now, interrogative, they are very simple. Wherever you will see a question, you will find that there is an interrogative pronoun. But relative pronouns are which type of pronouns? They are used to relate the parts of the sentence, means they are combining two sentences. For example, I have given here, this is the dress that you gifted me. Now see, if I remove this that from here, suppose there is no that here, suppose. So what are the two sentences, two parts of the sentence? This is the dress, this is first part of the sentence, and the second part of the sentence is you gifted me. Now if I talk about these parts of the sentence, this is the dress, you gifted me. Are they related to each other? They are the two different sentences. So when I am going to combine these two sentences, this is the dress that you gifted me. Now here this that is combining the first sentence with the second sentence. The first sentence is this is the dress. The second sentence is you gifted me. And this that is combining both of these sentences. That is why this that is now relative pronoun, not your demonstrative pronoun, because it is not pointing towards a particular object. Is it pointing? It is not pointing towards a particular object. It is relating these two sentences. That is why this is your relative pronoun. So this point you should understand, that the pronouns which are used to relate the parts of the sentence, the two parts of the sentence, if the pronoun is combining the two, one part and this second part, if it is combining the two parts of the sentence, then that is your relative pronoun. Don't think that who, whom, whose, they are only what? Interrogative pronoun only. It is not like that. You just have to see whether if they are used in the sentence to combine the two parts, then it becomes your relative pronoun. This is the pen which you bought for me. For example, I take a second example. This is the pen which you bought for me. Now see here, which, if you will simply go on the examples, for according to that, the which should be the interrogative pronoun. But here this which is not asked for us, is not used for asking the question. So which is not your interrogative pronoun. Here now, see what is the function of which in this sentence? This is the pen you bought for me. Two sentences are there. Which is combining the two sentences. So which will be your relative pronoun, not the interrogative pronoun. I hope you must have understood the difference between interrogative and relative pronoun. Just see the function of the pronoun. If it is asking the question, then it is interrogative pronoun. And if it is combining the two parts of the sentence, then it is your relative pronoun. Okay, now let's move to the next pronoun, that is reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun, let us read the definition. These pronouns are used when an action done by the subject turns back or reflects on the subject. Turns back or reflects on the subject. See here. What are these? Example, myself, yourself, themselves, etc. For example, I cleaned my room myself. Now see, if I don't write here myself, if the sentence is only this, I cleaned my room. Sentence is complete or not? Yes, it is complete. If I will not write myself, then also the sentence is complete. But why I am writing this myself? Because I want to make it sure. I want to reflect the work done by me. I am cleaning the room now. So I want to reflect that I have done it myself. If I only write I cleaned my room, then also it is clear that I cleaned my room, that the cleaning of room was done by me. But here myself is reflecting the action back. It is telling me back again, yes, it is done by me only. So that is what reflexive pronoun. It is turning back or reflecting back the action of the subject. What is the action? What is the subject here? I. Who is doing the action? That is the subject. And what is the action of the subject? Cleaning of the room. So subject is cleaning the room. I am cleaning the room. But myself is doing what? It is reflecting again back. It is telling me back again that room is cleaned by me only. So that is what is meaning of reflexive pronoun, and usually they are like this only: myself, yourself, themselves, himself, herself, them, her, themselves, etc. So you can easily find out in the sentences this reflexive pronouns. Now next comes your emphasizing pronouns. Now these are similar to reflexive pronoun. Now see, first read the definition. Pronouns that are used to add emphasis or add more importance. Pronouns that are used to add emphasis or add more importance. Emphasis means giving more importance. Laying importance on something. Telling that thing again and again. That is called emphasis. Now see, here examples are also same. Like myself, yourself, and these are the examples of reflexive pronoun also. Myself, yourself. Then how you will differentiate between reflexive and emphasizing pronoun? See, now same example I have taken to make it clear. I cleaned my room myself. I myself cleaned the room. The meaning of both the sentences is same. But here myself is reflexive pronoun and here myself is emphasizing pronoun. Hi. How? See, here myself is doing what? Here myself is laying emphasis on I. It is giving more importance to I. That is why here myself is emphasizing pronoun. Here, I myself cleaned the room. Only me. It means only I have cleaned my room. Nobody has helped me. Here myself is reflecting the action of the subject, but here myself is laying emphasis on I. That is why here myself is the emphasizing pronoun. And you can also use it as a trick, what I am going to tell you. But you cannot use it like in higher classes. But here now you can simply use this trick that reflexive pronouns, mostly they occur at the end of the sentence, and emphasizing pronouns, mostly they occur at the beginning of the sentence. But don't think that always emphasizing pronouns will be used at the beginning of the sentence only. It is not like that. But mostly, I'm saying mostly, not always. So in this way also you can differentiate between reflexive and emphasizing pronoun. So I hope that you must have understood, because I have found that students mostly get confused between interrogative and relative pronoun. Interrogative pronoun, because their examples are same. But only you have to see how they have been used in the sentence. If they are used to ask the question, then they are interrogative pronoun. If they are used to relate the two parts of the sentence, then they are relative pronoun. It should be clear to you. And students also get confused in between reflexive and emphasizing pronoun when they have to find out this. I think this is now understood to all of you. So today we have learned about the seven types of pronoun. And what are those seven types of pronouns? Let us revise once again. Personal pronoun, taking the place of person, place or thing. It includes first person, second person and third person. First person, who is speaking, that is I, and plural form is we. Second person, to whom I am speaking, that is you. And third person, about whom we are speaking, it may be he, she or it, and the plural form is they. Then the second type of pronoun is possessive pronoun, which shows the possessions, like who is having the things or the objects, like yours, mine, hers, his, etc. Then demonstrative pronoun, the pronouns that are used to point out object or objects, like that, this, these, those, etc. Then interrogative pronouns that are used to ask the questions, like what, who, which, etc. Then fifth type of pronoun is relative pronoun, that are used to relate the parts of the sentence, like who, that, whom, whose, etc. Reflexive pronoun, the pronouns are used when an action done by the subject turns back or reflects on the subject. For example, myself, yourself, themselves, etc. Emphasizing pronoun, pronouns that are used to add emphasis or add more importance. For example, again, myself, yourself, etc. Now see, if I speak one sentence, you have to do the homework yourself. Now here, you have to do the homework yourself. Yourself is what? Reflexive pronoun or emphasizing pronoun? Yes, it is reflexive pronoun. Because here now yourself is doing what? Throwing back the action on you again. What is the action of you? Doing the homework. So it is throwing back the action of doing the homework on you again. That is why it is the reflexive pronoun. And if I say, you yourself do the homework, then here yourself is what? Reflexive or emphasizing? It is emphasizing pronoun. Why? Because it is giving importance to you that you only have to do your homework, nobody else. You yourself have to do the homework. So just you have to see that what, whether it is giving emphasis or whether it is throwing back the action of the subject on the subject again, according to that you will see whether it is reflexive pronoun or emphasizing pronoun. So I hope now year 6 that there should be no problem with pronouns. Now already I explained in Zoom class also, now I am taking this, I am explaining you in the video also. So in the homework I am going to give you one revision sheet of pronoun, worksheet of pronoun. So please go through this material. I am going to give you in the reading material all the details of the pronoun. Go through the reading material of the pronoun and do the worksheet very carefully. Now, I hope you must have understood about the pronouns. Thank you for learning on Best Montessori Distance Learning ePortal. See you in next English class very soon.